Fotografía.
Steve Farhood, you're considered by many the number one expert in boxing. What do you have in your hand right now? And I think it's a book that every boxing fan should get. What is it exactly?
This is a book by the CompuBox gentleman, Bobby Kenobi and Lee Groves. And Lee is about 2 feet away.
How you doing, Lee?
Pretty well, how about you?
And Elie, this is a book I wish I had written. Let me put it that way. It's very hard to come up with anything new on Muhammad Ali because there have been about 5,000 books on him, of course.
Everything, movies, documentaries.
Yeah. And this is brand new. And I urge every boxing fan to get this. What this does is break down all of Ali's fights, statistically, just like CompuBox would do for, you know, Leo Santa Cruz and Abner Maris. And it's fascinating because most of Ali's fights are available to be broken down, and it's a statistical breakdown with a copy about each fight. And Lee is, for research, Lee is the best there is, so let him tell you a little bit more
about it. So Lee, first of all, people watching this, where do they purchase it?
They can purchase it on Amazon. It's available. Already has 1 5-star rating. Thanks to him.
That's awesome.
So see if it stands up.
And what's the official name? Is it Muhammad Ali by the Numbers?
It's Muhammad Ali by the Numbers. And we break down Ali's career into 4 distinct phases. The young Ali, the prime Ali, which was his first title reign. The comebacking Ali, starting with the Quarry fight through Frazier 3. And then the past prime Ali, which is Koopman on to the end of Burbick. And the most shocking thing about this particular study is that Ali was hit a lot more by his opponents than you would think, even as a young man.
Unfortunately, the health results showed it.
It did. It really did.
But everybody say he did the rope-a-dope, he never got touched, he slipped all the punches, but he got hit.
Yeah, he did.
Interesting.
And another very interesting wrinkle to this book is that thanks to Bob Yalen, we also have a lot of the scorecards, and you can compare the punch numbers to how the judges scored each round. Like, the Jimmy Young fight is particularly interesting. In round 1, Ali was outlanded 18-0, but 2 of the judges gave it even.
Just like today, nothing has changed. But I gotta ask you a few questions. Right off the bat.
Yeah.
Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali, who wins?
Wow, that is a very tough fight. But you know, in light of the defensive deficiencies that has been uncovered, Mike Tyson is most dangerous early, very early. He's a very fast starter. Ali is very resilient, though. And you have to also take into account the psychological attack that Ali Clay would impose on Tyson. So you wonder if Tyson can keep his head and if he can get off to a good start, he has a chance. But if he is bothered by the taunts and all the tactics, and also Ali's considerable speed and boxing ability, what Buster Douglas did, Ali could do even more of it. I would say Ali by decision.
What do you say, Steve?
Styles make fights, we all know that, but I think more so in the heavyweight division, Elie, than in any other division. And you look at A beats B, B beats C, that doesn't mean A beats C. We know Ali would have trouble every time with Frazier, and if Frazier fought Foreman 100 times, he'd get knocked out 100 times. And yet Ali beat Foreman. So that's an example of styles making fights. To me, Tyson Ali is a classic example of that. There's not a doubt in my mind Muhammad Ali would win because he had a great chin. Yes, he went down, but he always got up. And I think he would have weathered the early storm of Tyson, and then he would have outboxed Tyson in the later rounds. So even a prime Tyson, who I think at this point is a little underrated, because everybody loves to, you know, revisionist history, right? I think even a prime Tyson Ali, a prime Ali certainly would have beaten. But then again, I would pick a prime Ali against Joe Lewis. I would pick a prime Ali against any heavyweight in history.
Some people knock CompuBox. Yes. They say it's not accurate. How does it work for those who don't know?
Well, you have 2 operators. One operator is assigned each fighter. We hit 1 of 6 buttons. Miss jab, landed jab, landed jab to the body. Miss power punch, landed power punch, landed power punch to the body. Anything that is not a jab is a power punch in CompuBox's world, because the theory is that if a fighter jabs effectively, then everything else about his offense follows. And it usually comes to pass. There is about a 2% margin of error as far as accuracy is concerned. But I believe that if you have 2 experienced operators at ringside and you have a monitor at the workstation so that you can cover the angles that are not favorable in the live action, you could have an even lower margin of error. So the reality is that if CompuBox, CompuBox has done a very good job of tracking blows through the years. And if we weren't good at what we do, we wouldn't be here right now. CompuBox would not be putting out a book about Muhammad Ali, and it wouldn't be believable.
And to echo something Lee said, Elie, I work as an unofficial judge on a lot of these fights, and you know, I have the same advantage Lee and the punch counters have, which is that when the fighters are tucked in the opposite corner and the referees block on my view, I just instinctively look at the monitor and I can see. The real judges obviously don't have that luxury. And Lee, who's been doing this for a long time, knows when to look at the live action and when to look at the monitor. So you do get a more of a complete look than even the judges do.
Okay, my last question. If Muhammad Ali was still alive, what would he say about the book?
He'd probably hype it real well, as nobody else could, and the book sales would go through the roof because Muhammad Ali was hyping it.
He is still the most recognizable face in sports.
He is. He really is. He's a global figure. He's a political figure. He's a sporting figure. He's an icon. He is the definition of icon, and his reach is beyond just about anybody, athlete or non-athlete. He is known by everybody. Whether first world, second world, third world, any world, they know who Muhammad Ali is, and he's earned that.
Absolutely, there you have it. The only person in Hollywood Boulevard to have a star on the wall, not on the ground.
There you go.
Wow.
You guys know why?
They don't want Muhammad Ali on the ground because that shows that he went down and he always got up.
No, because the name Muhammad, he didn't want people stepping on it.
Right.
So it went on the wall. But there you have it. Muhammad Ali, by the numbers. Check it out. Amazon, correct?
Amazon.com.
There you have it. EsNews.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.